This is the image of a woman, born princess, yet decided to give her queenship at the call from a greater king, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of Kings. Leaving all the luxury and pomp of her palace, she opted for a life of charity and mortification. Though all considered her a saint, soon after her death, it took 800 years to get her official recognition as a canonized saint. She is Agnes of Bohemia, also known as Agnes of Prague. Agnes was born in 1211 as the daughter of King Otto I of Bohemia and her mother, Constance of Hungary. It was the wish of her father that she should marry from the royalty of the highest reputation in Europe. In fact, there were many great kings who longed for the hand of Agnes, like Henry III of England and Frederick II, the Holy Roman Emperor. Though kings and queens in the court had been negotiating the marriage, Agnes had already vowed herself a life to be the eternal bride of Jesus. Though this enraged her lover, Emperor Frederick, he was ready to accept the decision of Agnes. It is reported that he said the following words: "If she had left me for a mortal man, I would have taken vengeance with the sword, but I cannot take offense because in preference to me, she has chosen the King of Heaven." Her greatest inspiration was Saint Clara of Assisi. With her she continued prolonged correspondence over 20 years, though they had never met. Saint Clare so loved the Czech princess so much and called her half of her soul and sent her in support 5 of her nuns. It was with their support Agnes started the first Franciscan monastery in Prague. In 1235, Agnes gave the property of the Teutonic Knights in Bohemia to build a hospital. She herself became a member of the Franciscan Poor Clares in 1236. As a nun, she cooked and mended the clothes of lepers and paupers, even after becoming abbess of the Prague of Clares the following year. It was the sagacity of Agnes which resulted in the formation of a lay group working at the hospital, a newly created order only for the nursing of the sick, known as the Knights of the Cross. Agnes lived out her life in the cloister, leading the monastery as abbess, until her death on the 2nd of March 1282. It was only in 1989 she was canonized by Pope John Paul II, 800 years after her death.